हकुना मटाटा, दिस इज आवर मैथ्स मास्टर टीचर एट वेदांतु। आज का सेशन भी कुछ फन होने वाला है। आई विल बी परफॉर्मिंग एन एक्टिविटी फॉर यू गाइस, क्योंकि बहुत सारे बच्चों ने रिक्वेस्ट किया कि मैम सरफेस एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम्स में बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, बहुत फॉर्मूलाज हैं, कैसे याद करें। तो बेटा, याद करने का फंडा यही है कि अगर आप उस शेप को अच्छे से विजुलाइज कर लोगे तो फॉर्मूला एग्जामिनेशन हॉल में क्या कहीं भी बैठे बैठे आप डिराइव कर लोगे। तो मेरा इस एक्टिविटी का मोटिव यही है कि आपको एक अच्छी सी विजुलाइजेशन दे दूं ताकि आप फॉर्मूलाज कभी ना भूलो। तो स्टार्ट हम करेंगे आज सिलेंडर से। टुडे वी विल बी परफॉर्मिंग एन एक्टिविटी टू कैलकुलेट द कर्व सर्फेस एरिया एंड टोटल सर्फेस एरिया ऑफ अ सिलेंडर, एंड इन माय कमिंग अपकमिंग वीडियोस आई विल बी गिविंग द फॉर्मूलाज, deriving the formulas for other shapes as well. All right, so let's begin with our today's session. Cylinder is a very common shape. If you look around you can find so many cylindrical shapes. For example, the pencil you use, or the curtain rods, and so many other. Even I have so many cylindrical shapes with me as well. This shuttle box, the tape roll, the tin can, the bottle, these are all cylindrical shapes, right? So in this session, we are going to find out the area of the cylinder, basically the surface area I'm talking about. So, and it is going to be really, really, very interesting. So take a look at the cylinder. It has two parts, this curved part as well as it has these two circular bases with it. Now two terms come into our mind. First is the curved surface area and the second is the total surface area. Curved surface area is basically this part of the cylinder, the curved part, this blue part. And if I talk about the total surface area, it adds this circular basis to this blue part, right? So to understand, to figure out how do we calculate this curved surface area, I am taking this reference cylinder with me, okay? So that you can understand it better. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to cut the cylinder vertically. Like this. Let's find out what do we get. Okay, now I have cut the cylinder vertically. When I open it, it looks like a rectangle, isn't it? So now two questions comes to our mind. First is, what will be the length of this rectangle and what is going to be the breadth of this rectangle? In order to find the curved surface area, what we have to do is we have to just find the area of this rectangle. Isn't it easy? Now, if you look carefully, you can see that the length of this rectangle is basically the length of the circular base. Like if I roll it into the cylinder again, this length is basically the length of the circular base. Which is what? Which is the circumference of the circle. So I can say that the length is going to be the circumference of the circle, which is 2 pi r. And what about the breadth? Let me roll it for you again. Now if I say this is the cylinder and I take this as a reference cylinder, right? So this breadth is actually equal to the height of the cylinder. Can you guys notice? This breadth is going to be equal to the height of the cylinder. So what do we get? We get length as 2 pi r and breadth as height. So what will be the area of this rectangle? Length into breadth, that is 2 pi r into h. And that becomes the curved surface area of our cylinder. Now let's try to find out what will be the total surface area of the cylinder. Now the total surface area is basically the area of this curved part plus the area of these two circular bases, right? Now we have already calculated the area of this curved part using this rectangle, right? Now let's calculate the area of this circular bases. I have taken these two circular bases. So what will be the total surface area? It will going to be the area of this part plus the area of these two circles, right? So what will be the area of this part? That we have already calculated, this area is 2 pi rh. And what will be the area of these two circular bases? These are going to be pi r square and pi r square. Now if I will add these three areas, I will get the total surface area of the cylinder, isn't it? So what do we conclude here? Let's see. So we conclude that the total surface area of the cylinder is equal to the curved surface area plus the area of the top and base, right? So curved surface area is, we already calculated 2 pi r h, and plus the circular basis area becomes pi r square plus pi r square. If r is the radius, it is not going to change, right? So let's simplify it further. 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. I am taking 2 pi r common, and bracket me I will get h plus r. So this becomes the total surface area of the cylinder, and the curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So that was all. Visualization makes things easier, right? If you like the video, do tell me in the comment section, and do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more fun videos like this. Bye bye.